jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long.
What's up guys, it's Josh. We are back again with another video. I have made a what to bring to college video in the past. If you haven't checked that out yet, definitely go check that out. It talks about all the college essentials that you're probably forgetting about for your dorm room. But in today's video, we're gonna focus on all the things you should absolutely not bring to college. I had a lot of things that I brought to college my freshman year that I just never ended up using, or maybe they were just taking up useless space. And today I have brought you a list of 5 things that you want to avoid bringing to college. For those of you that don't know, my name is Josh Beasley. I'm a rising sophomore at Yale University studying electrical engineering and computer science. My channel mainly consists of Yale vlogs, sit down videos like this, and maybe some student interviews. I've done some college application stuff in the past, really just trying to share my life in college. It's a great way for me to grow and to look back on in the future. If you're a fan of that, definitely subscribe. More great content coming soon. Without any further ado, let's get into the 5 things that I recommend leaving at home. First of all, when you're packing up your clothes for college, you're gonna be very tempted to bring all those high school like t-shirts, you know, like, oh, I was on varsity baseball at Herndon High School. I gotta rep my t-shirt, gotta rep the team. No, no you don't. No one, I mean, some people do, but no one wears high school gear in college. You're in college now. That's a new stage of your life. Don't be wearing your like national merit finalist t-shirt during college. Please don't do that. Don't be that guy, okay? Leave that stuff at home. Also, college, you'll find that especially throughout orientation and as you begin getting involved in more extracurriculars and stuff, you're going to get countless t-shirts throughout the year. I think I've probably accumulated between 10 to 15 t-shirts just throughout this year, whether it's like t-shirts from the Harvard-Yale game, t-shirts for events in my residential college. There's also a lot of t-shirts for extracurriculars, Greek life, stuff like that. You will accumulate a lot of college t-shirts, and those are the ones you're gonna wanna wear, not your old high school stuff. So, take your letter jacket, take all your old high school stuff, leave it at home. It's where it belongs. I know it hurts, but you're now entering college, a new stage in your life. Refresh, you won't regret it. Item number 2 is school supplies. Now, you're not gonna wanna leave all your school supplies at home. If you looked into my backpack last year, I would have my laptop, I would have 2 notebooks, 2 folders, and then pencils and pens. Even that was a little bit overboard, but it's gonna be nothing like high school where you have like a binder for each class, or like maybe you try to stick all your classes into one giant binder. Binders, they need to stay in high school, okay? Like very rarely will you have to use a binder in college. You'll find that a lot more of your assignments and stuff are going to be taken on your laptop. I personally do not like taking notes on a laptop or an iPad. I prefer to do handwritten notes, especially when it comes to like my engineering classes and physics classes, math classes, where you have to do a lot of drawings and stuff. I find myself not being able to do that on an iPad, or not being able to do it the way I want it to be portrayed. Also, I don't like looking back at like trying to find notes on an iPad when I can just flip through the pages of my notebook, and those are the same pages that I'll do my PSETs in and all that stuff. So I prefer personally to take notes in notebooks. So normally I'll have maybe a notebook for 2 classes, and I have 4 or 5 classes each semester, so 2 notebooks is normally pretty good. I don't take a ton of notes. A lot of times lecture notes will be posted online, but just anything that's important during class I'll write down, and that will normally throughout a total semester take up like half a notebook. So that's what I found works for me. But hey, if you like taking notes on your laptop, you like taking notes on your iPad, feel free to do that. A lot of people do it. A lot of people love doing that. Do whatever you want. If you don't want to carry around notebooks, don't do it. But I definitely would recommend keeping pencils and pens, whether it be for editing essays, or you're definitely gonna need pencils and pens when it comes to taking tests. That's very important. Definitely have those prepared. But like, you won't need 2 sets of colored pencils, a set of thin Crayola markers. Like you don't need all that stuff that they like list out you needed in like middle school or whatever. Just leave that at home. Maybe bring a highlighter or 2, a couple Sharpies, but that's really it. Really bare bones. Most of the stuff will be on your computer. All right, item number 3 is room decorations, dorm room decorations. A lot of times this is like, at least for me, I've always shared a room with my brother throughout my entire like childhood life, because there's 5 kids in my family. That's the way we had to do it. And I never really got invested into my room. You know, it was just somewhere I slept. But once you get to your dorm room and you like meet your roommate and you set everything up, you kind of have this feeling that it's finally like, this is your first like independent room that's on your own that you can decorate or do whatever you want with. So I kind of went overboard a lot with that, bought a lot of useless decorations and stuff that I just never ended up using, and they just only take up space. Don't bring all your like knickknacks or like high school trophies or stuff that you have sitting on your desk at home. Although those are cool, maybe bring a couple of those. Like they don't have, you don't have enough room to bring those to college, and they just take up useless space. My dorm room freshman year was super tiny. Like we had a room that was meant to be a single, but we had two people sharing a bunk bed in there. It was an absolute mess. Did not have any room for that. Posters are okay, but when it comes to like little knickknacks and stuff, just leave them at home. You're not gonna have space for them once you get to school. That's my biggest tip when it comes to that type of stuff. Definitely invest in decorating your room, but tone it down a little bit, all right? And you should be okay. Item number four is, once again, another tip when it comes to clothing. You do have breaks throughout your college semester. You go there first semester, you'll probably go home for Thanksgiving break, and you'll go home for Christmas, which means that you do not need to bring all of your clothes for every single season to school when you arrive on the first day. Like personally for me, I brought my shorts, I brought my t-shirts, I brought all of that type of stuff because, I mean, up in New Haven, it's still warm for like the first two, almost 3 months that you're there before it starts getting rainy and snowy and gross. So I basically had all my warm clothes, maybe a couple pairs of pants, a couple long sleeve t-shirts and a light coat all up until Thanksgiving break. When it came time for Thanksgiving break, that's when I went and grabbed my heavy coat, my boots, and everything that I would need just in case it started snowing before Christmas break, and it did end up snowing before Christmas break, so I was glad I brought all that stuff. Even if you didn't, you can come back for winter break, celebrate with your family, and then once you're back to school, have all the super, super heavy stuff, depending on where you're living. If you're going to like USC or something, obviously your clothing's gonna be pretty much the same year round. But up in New Haven, weather absolutely sucks and it's just absolutely nasty for like 4 months out of the year. So we definitely need some warmer clothing and more clothing that's suited for rain, snow, sleet, all the crap we get up there. So in conclusion, don't bring all your clothes at once. You have time to go home and grab specific clothes for specific seasons. That will make your closet a lot less full and make moving in and moving out a lot more manageable. All right, item number five is more of a general thing. Basically, don't bring anything your roommate's bringing. As I said in that video, me and my roommate Jake really didn't talk to each other that much during the summer, didn't really coordinate who was bringing what. We just said, hey, we're gonna wing it when we get there. Wasn't the best idea. I had to like go buy a fridge and a microwave all once we got there because we didn't know who was gonna bring it. So definitely coordinate with your roommate. You don't need two chairs, you don't need two fridges, you don't need two microwaves. Coordinate who's bringing what so you don't have duplicate stuff in your room. And it will also make it a lot more manageable when you're moving in. You don't have extra stuff everywhere. In conclusion, communicate with your roommate. Super important. As soon as you know who they are, communicate. And hopefully moving in will be a lot easier on you. So, in conclusion, those were the five things I recommend leaving at home when it comes to moving into college. Definitely listen to these. Otherwise, you're just gonna have extra stuff sitting around your room. If you found this video helpful, if you got something from it, if you're excited for college, leave a thumbs up down below. It helps me and supports the channel a lot more than you think. Comment down below any questions, comments, concerns, future video ideas. I will try to respond to you guys. If you're new, subscribe. More great content coming soon. And with that, I'll see you guys in the next video.